So now that you know how hydrochloric acid and pepsinogen are synthesized and secreted, we're going to look at what regulates their synthesis and secretion, because you can't just randomly synthesize and secrete hydrochloric acid and pepsinogen. So this regulation of hydrochloric acid and pepsinogen involves the cephalic phase, the gastric phase, and the intestinal phase. Here we go. We're going to go through each of these phases. Okay, so we're going to start with the cephalic phase. So remember, the stimulus for the cephalic phase originates in the head. All right, so we're going to be thinking in terms of the brain, right? Remember the goal. What regulates secretion of hydrochloric acid and pepsinogen? So we're going to start off with the stimuli. So the stimuli are the sight, the smell, the taste, and the thoughts of food. So that's going to stimulate the central nervous system. Now, once the central nervous system is stimulated, that's going to stimulate the parasympathetic fibers. Remember that that's the vagus nerve, because we're dealing with the parasympathetic system. We've stimulated the vagus nerve. So action potentials will travel down that vagus nerve, and then we'll synapse here with the neurons in the submucosal plexus. Remember, the submucosal plexus is in the gut wall, right? It's the submucosal layer of the gut wall. Remember, too, that the submucosal plexus, the whole goal of it is to secrete. So here you have the parasympathetic nervous system communicating to the submucosal plexus, which then stimulates the mucus cells to synthesize and secrete mucus. The submucosal plexus will stimulate the chief cells to synthesize and secrete pepsinogen. The submucosal plexus will stimulate the parietal cells to synthesize and secrete hydrochloric acid. So all of these now are in the lumen. Now, the submucosal plexus also stimulates the G cells that are in the gut. The G cells will then synthesize and secrete gastrin, which is your hormone. So gastrin is synthesized and secreted by the stomach, and it's the submucosal plexus that's responsible for gastrin being synthesized and secreted. So before we continue, I want to ask you a question. The submucosal plexus, remember we said that these contain adrenergic and cholinergic neurons? What type of neurons are we dealing with here? Cholinergic or adrenergic? These should be cholinergic neurons, right? We're stimulating digestion. Okay. Now, once gastrin has been produced, gastrin's going to go out into the blood, because hormones travel out into the bloodstream. And then what gastrin's going to do is, through the blood, not through the submucosal plexus, but through the blood, it's going to stimulate the parietal cells. And it's going to stimulate the chief cells. So when you stimulate the parietal cells, then that's going to cause more synthesis and secretion of hydrochloric acid. And then the chief cells are going to synthesize and secrete more pepsinogen. So by gastrin going out into the blood, here we're reinforcing the parasympathetic nervous system. The actions of the parasympathetic nervous system are reinforced by gastrin going into the blood, traveling through the blood, and then targeting those parietal cells and those chief cells. This phase does not last very long, literally minutes. Okay, remember, it's a cephalic phase. The stimulus originates in the head. It's originating with the sight and the smell and the taste or the thought of eating. That's what's originating or causing this cephalic phase. So what's going to turn it off? So to turn off the cephalic phase, remove the stimulus. Because if the stimulus is gone, there's no action potential traveling down the vagus nerve. And therefore, you're not going to create a slow wave potential in the submucosal plexus.